do, huh? Kind of like I'm here for your entertainment. How's that?
Oh, shit.
There you have it. What I do. Big Ford sticker in the back window. Ford 300. Ford something. Car. Car. Got no time for them. Probably somebody don't belong. That's how this neighborhood goes. Nobody here. Ever. The neighbor. He had surgery. Oh, I gotta go see the neighbor. Really?
Oh, I know.
Damn it. Damn it, Jesus. Okay, I'm gonna go see the neighbor. What, are you crazy?
Have some kind of serious surgery or
something like that? Is it that kind of simple?
They made it that way.
Really?
7 hours to get it out.
It's not like...
They cut me here, peeled my face down, cut a chunk of my skull out, went in there and imploded it and sucked it out. Back in and put some titanium screws in and then they like a sewing machine or something. They sewed me up and then super glued it.
Yeah, they used that super glue down my hand. That's neat stuff. Yeah.
So yeah. Now it's cool enough, and you can tell right here, it went all the way down.
Because back in the day, you know, it was like you couldn't get oxygen to the brain or this or that, and it was like deadly, and that makes it look like it was an outpatient.
I suppose we intensive care for 3 days.
Well, but you're a healthy individual, probably, too, like me.
Yeah, and they want to get you out of the hospital because the hospital's number of petri dishes.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We're a lot worse. Over in Chile, they have one of two copper hospitals with copper inside to keep you. It doesn't let pathogens live. Copper doesn't, like ours over in the States. I know. But it's me too, but you're out here just fucking with the bees again.
Yeah.
Pain is your friend is what the Marines say. It's good to feel pain. Pain lets you know you're still alive. And you can eat too many pain pills and not know the kind of pain you're going to die, you know.
Well, I was
on
Oxycontin.
Dose,
and I thought, when's the next time I could take some? I didn't have any pain, I was paranoid.
Right,
no,
I'll bet.
Can you see what it's like without them?
My aunt didn't like any of them. She took that shit. She said, Robbie, the type of person that I felt, she was like, I didn't know who I was. She said, I'd rather have a cane. I was like, man, that's kind of weird to think
that's
like that.
Crazy.
Not me.
Oh,
I wouldn't love that.
See, now me, I'm just like happy
in heaven.
That part didn't bother me.
But no, I know what you mean. I mean, yeah. Not nowadays. Back in the day, I used to like that. But yeah.
Yeah, and adversity back in the day, you may have a personality change. Like, what's that mean? I come home, and all my interests, I was just doing inventory on my V stuff and sell it off. And give a little time, and then I started reading and got back into that, and I'm like, I like that again now. You know, but I was, at first I was like, oh, I hope my personality doesn't quit.
I hope it's okay. It turns me into a genius or something like that, but that didn't happen.
Well,
so.
You might be. You know, you never know. Well, it's like a supercomputer. It's going to take a minute for it to reboot what's going on. You know? Well, plus that was under frustration, and so, you know, I mean, I imagine you're probably like
getting
the fans. But, I mean, you got to do what you got to do at this point, and, but you're still questioning. That's got to be tough for a brain to go through that.
I went in on Wednesday with that consultation. I had to go to Chicago because they didn't want to mess with it because it was too big.
Thank God.
Yeah.
So you really trust me?
No, no. I went in on a Tuesday and said, okay, we can do it on Monday. Do you want or anything? We just got to get
right.
It done.
Right. Well, thank God.
Right.
You know, that
didn't give me a chance to
right.
In
right. Thank God. Right.
Right.
Don't let me talk myself out of it. Thank you. There's somebody on my side.
Right.
Takes this more serious to understand.
I remember they're looking up the IVs and stuff, and they said, okay, we're going to give you a little shot of something to calm you down before we actually knock you out. And you went, next thing I know, how you feeling? That's the time
lapse. Nice. Well, at least they don't tell you anymore. It's count backwards for you too.
Yeah.
No, just, yeah, you're going to be all right. See ya.
They
yeah.
Woke me up and said, how you feeling? Like, wow, this is what you get, I'm good.
Yeah.
I don't pay
you see the Oscars.
Yeah.
You're like, hold on, wait, no. Oh my gosh. You know, it might be Rob, the neighbor out in the backyard, but no ostrich.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, because to us, we don't know.
Right.
You know what I mean? And then, like, and nowadays, I mean, it sounds like certain other places, not Lakeland, but they've got that shit down good.
Oh, man, I got it down. Yeah. It comes with a price. I got to go to a doctor.
Yeah, you
right?
Have.
They take my... Oh, yeah. The insurance don't pay for everything.
No, I learned that.
They
pay what they
like
want.
Them.
Yeah, that's why every time I play, I always pay. I have a bill and it's like, that's not my idea of insurance.
Right.
I thought it was 80-40 or some shit.
No,
or
of what they decide.
Yeah.
We're going to take $20
yeah.
of $1,000 bill.
Right. It's whatever they decide.
Right.
And then if they don't decide, it's like, that's not what my insurance carrier means to me. My insurance carrier to me means... I go there and you pay everything, and if something ain't paid, you're fighting the battle for me to get it paid.
Right.
And not just fucking Bill Rob,
right.
The ref.
The hell's settling down, so we're going to say this, we're going to accept that.
Nope.
Send the rest to Jerry.
Yeah.
Fuck it. I'm done fighting.
Yeah.
No, that's not insurance carry. Insurance carry to me is you're my litigator. You're supposed to fight that battle for me, especially, yeah, like this shit, you know?
Right.
And then you have the brain surgery, dude. I'm lucky to be fucking alive. You should be happy to pay my fucking bill. Matter of fact, you should be bragging. We saved a guy, and we paid his bill.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? How better to get my insurance from me? I'd be like, shit, I'm going with you.
Well, here's the thing. We go to the
sit down and talk to the doctor, and you're in there a total of 20 minutes, and you get $1,000 bill. I'm like, I can go down to Walgreens, get my blood pressure
yeah.
checked, and mail it to you, or call you up and tell you.
You're not just right about this, is
no.
I'm hoping Trump throws that out.
Yeah, before they totally get rid of Obamacare, they need to come up with something better. Because
somebody who can just step out there like Grandma would do and just go, I'm just not standing for it.
Right, right. Well, what I want to keep is pre-existing things.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Because now I
they have to.
Because now I yeah. When I get out of the
insurance, I don't see him getting rid of that.
No.
You know, he's not like, he's not cutthroat like that. He's trying to stop guys who are 16 babies into still on the system, and it's like, why?
Right.
You know? Or like refugees that are going to Canada. Canada's saying, we'll accept you. Well, yeah, there you go, people. You don't have to go to Mexico, back to Mexico, but go that way. Right. We're done taking care of you for now. You want to register as a citizen, we'll take care of you. Otherwise, go that way. You know? I don't want to, though. Everybody wants to freeze it. No, he's not trying to fuck people like us. He's trying to fix the system so
he's
that
doing
we're not...
exactly what he said he was going to do when he was rough campaigning. And now people can't take it.
No.
He's not pulled no strings.
Well, and we're the working class.
Right.
We're the ones that are down in the mine pits that they're cracking the whips on and shit. We're not the ones that don't deserve the meal. You know what I mean?
Fuck.
Hey, I'm glad to see you're alive. You're doing well. I'm going to tell Mom and them you're doing well.
Yep, Terry's well.
Yeah. All right. You have a good one.
Yeah, you too. Tell Ryan and the family I said hi.
All right, I sure will.
I'm going to my second job.
You know, next Saturday is supposed to be 60.
I wouldn't count on it.
Yeah, but that's brutal.
I think they're changing the barometric pressures somehow and trying and doing with mixed with their chemicals or whatever they're doing. I'm not sure, whatever, but
yeah, it's CO2 in the atmosphere.
Something. Dry ice, dropping it at certain times, thinking that's going to emit humidity.
Who knows?
They're doing something crazy and it really ain't working. Mother Nature has a way of fixing herself.
Yep.
Just like us. Feel it. Terry. There he goes. Brain surgery. Crazy. Walking around. Inpatient, outpatient, kinda. That's how we roll out here. We're having fun. Neighbors having brain surgery. Lucky to be alive. Insane. There we go. That's that. That's, we got nobody around. Neighbors have brain surgery. You know, we're in the middle of nowhere sometimes. Not really. Like, there's a neighbor. There's a church, for instance. We have a church. Fucking right close. I mean, it's not our church. It's a church. Well, you know what I mean. Alright. We might as well film the whole ride, alright? Kind of scenery I see. Badass.